everyone. This is Jana Stafford with BIC Magazine. And joining me today is Micheal VanDerSnick, the Senior Vice President for American Manufacturing with LyondellBasell. Welcome, Mike.
Good to be with you today.
Thank you very much. I'm excited to talk about LyondellBasell's Center for Petrochemical Energy and Technology at San Jacinto College. As I was telling you earlier, I went out there yesterday and was able to get a tour, and the director showed me all around the glass installation lab, the unit outside. It just was amazing. I took a ton of pictures and just can really see how this is going to be, it already is, such a great thing for training LyondellBasell, all industry employees, and of course, San Jacinto students. So could you tell us a little bit about the history between LyondellBasell and San Jac, and just kind of what led up to the center being developed and built?
Sure. Actually, LyondellBasell and San Jacinto College have a really strong history. I can think back to, well over a decade, certainly in the late 2000s. LyondellBasell has been working with the college, not only contributing financially, but also assisting with other programs that they've had. I think, you know, the relationship really started and really started to take off and grow when the college began seeking input, not just from LyondellBasell, but from industry in general, about how to work and develop and improve their programs. And I have to give them a lot of credit. They asked questions, and we gave them answers, and we talked about things that they did well, that their graduates did well, but also some things that we thought needed improvement. So that relationship started with listening and with an exchange of ideas and some suggestions for improvement around the current curriculum and the facilities. Now that developed over time to where I think San Jacinto recognized, saw a need for industry to develop and build this new center. And along the way, they continued to ask for advice and input about how to design the center, how to set up the curriculum, what type of teaching aids, what types of things industry needed to really improve the caliber and the quality of graduates from the program. Mm-hmm. So all along the way, they sought advice, they listened, and we contributed, not just ideas, but ultimately, of course, financial contributions to help develop the facility. And so what you saw when you saw the tour was kind of the culmination of that listening that began well over a decade ago and turning those ideas into reality. So the entire center incorporates much of the, not only the physical design, but what we envision as far as making the workforce of the future.
Wow, that's amazing. Yeah, that glass installation lab, I've never really understood completely. Well, not that I do now, but I've never even really had a close understanding of the process. And just to have that actual, you know, seeing it going, flowing through, it was really cool. It was really cool.
Yeah, that is the unique thing about the glass lab. It is, as you said, it's a hands-on scaled model of both the chemical and the physical processes that take place inside any one of our facilities, but in particular focuses on distillation. Many people have an opportunity occasionally to tour our actual operating facilities, and they see distillation columns, but they have, as you said, no concept of what's actually taking place in there. This glass mm-hmm. distillation lab allows students to see the physical processes, as I said, and trace and follow and learn. And it really helps bring out the education that we want.
Mm-hmm. And I'm sure just improving the workforce so much by having that hands-on training, of course.
Absolutely. So, I think it's going to help us build a better workforce for the future.
Yeah, for sure. Could you tell us a little bit, Mike, about the LyondellBasell volunteer, the volunteers that have to, like, that not have to, they're volunteering, but that sit on the committee for the CPET?
Sure. As I said, you know, this started out as a dialogue, you know, well over a decade ago, but the college basically has an advisory committee mm-hmm. in which they involve industry in terms of continuing to provide input in terms of the curriculum, providing feedback in terms of the caliber and quality of the graduates, of their technicians and their programs. But there's also an opportunity for us to turn some of those ideas into reality, mm-hmm. and the glass lab that you saw was really the result of the, what I would call the sweat equity from the working committee, that they put in, I can't tell you how many hours of their own time and not just Monday through Friday, but you know, all hours through the day. It was it's really been a vision and to use the term, a labor of love for them. They were really dedicated towards seeing this vision turn into a reality. And they've worked countless hours and came up with very innovative ideas. It took a lot of physical intelligence. It took a lot of, you know how to not only design a teaching tool, but to make it such that it was very effective in terms of translating the concepts into learning and ultimately what we think will make a great workforce.
Wow, that is amazing. And it was 2019, I think it was built or completed.
Actually, we had the, it's taken many months to build it, but the glass lab itself, if you're referring to that, we had the ribbon cutting for it earlier this year. So it was being built all throughout 2020, and that was a challenging year. But in some ways, it allowed that group to focus without too many distractions, if you will.
Distractions.
Yes, but the CPET itself opened up in 2019, as you said. Okay. But this latest edition of the glass lab is now available for teaching here in 2021.
Okay, wonderful. Well, thank you so much for telling me all about that. And I know this was like a really granular focused on CPET, so I wanted to, while we're here, open it up for you to just tell us anything there, you know, anything trending or anything going on industry-wise, or just LyondellBasell, just, you know, whatever you'd like to speak on, that would be great. Our audience would really appreciate that.
Well, I would talk, if I could, on behalf of industry. Our industry has seen tremendous growth over the past decade. And the reality of that is the processes that we've grown and invested in, they're up and running, and that creates a strong pull and a demand for the workforce. So, you know, I guess my message is, you know, we've grown, there will continue to be growth, but we're hiring, certainly with not only our company, but all industry in general. So that's why, you know, with regards to the Center for Petrochemical and Energy and Technology, the CPET, you know, this is a one-of-a-kind place. In my mind, we've helped with Sanjack develop probably one of the best, if not the best institution in the country to help create technicians for this workforce in the Gulf Coast area, which continues to grow and continues to hire. So, we've been proud of our partnership, but it's not just a benefit for us. In my mind, this facility was built, I would say, by industry for industry.
Right, yeah.
And in the end, you know, I think we'll help the students become graduates and ultimately, I think, the future leaders in our company.
I know your time is valuable, though, so we'll go ahead and wrap it up. And I just also want to thank our audience at BIC Magazine. Please like and share this video and visit BICmagazine.com to check out our podcasts, our webinars, and other videos for industry experts like Mike. And just remember, it's what we do together that counts.